So I wanted to do a quick video, give you guys an idea about some of the things that I ran across when I was building this room. Unique things and some of the things that I came up with and basically what the deal is with it. So it's obviously not a dedicated room. It is the downstairs of a raised ranch. Hella stove back there. It gets pretty cold in the winter, so not getting rid of that anytime soon. The room is 15 and a half by 19 and a half. Some French doors out to my deck. Closet, bathroom, laundry room. We'll get to that in a second. So I'll start with the rack. It's all Marantz. This is the 8077 MM8077 7 channel amp. This is the AV8802A processor, and I have three of the MM7025 2 channel amps that run all the other speakers in the ceiling and those. Panamax and an Oppo, and this is, what Oppo is this? The BDP-103. So, a unique thing about this, this is a Sanus Rex system. Got it on Amazon, I think. I don't remember. It was a while ago. And when I first put it in, first of all, they don't recommend you going over 5 shelves because I guess it gets a little wobbly, but obviously I went to the ceiling. So when I first put it in, I was, a lot of the bass builds up in this corner, like big time. You can't stand in this corner if there's something, a music or a movie going on. It's just so intense. But I was hearing this ringing sound and I couldn't figure out what it was. It was almost like a room ring, if you know what that is. It's like an acoustical thing, but, and I was like, couldn't figure out what the heck it was. So the rack system comes like this, and these are metal, and I don't know if you can hear it, but it was almost, I mean, they were ringing certain frequencies. Didn't happen all the time, but it just, once the bass hit it just right, it was like a tuning fork. So my solution was to cut some pipe insulation, which kind of goes along with the foam look. And then I just popped them in. I did it for all of them. All the way up the rack and all the way down in the back. Kind of gives it an industrial look. And beefs it up a little bit. So that was an interesting few weeks trying to figure out where that noise was coming from. Let's see, the speaker on the door. Before this I had Boston Acoustic speakers, and I did have it on the door, but it was a bipole speaker, and it was a lot lighter than the SVS Ultra bookshelves. I mean, these are pretty big speakers. It's hard to tell, but I think they're like 19 pounds. So, and this is just a hollow interior door. So I did have a friend make some, it's hard to tell back here, but they're high gloss acrylic plaques. It just kind of adds to the look of a finish, more of a finished look. It's hard to tell. I gotta get some better lighting in there. But this is the laundry room. This is how I... Nice. So here's a speaker. Wire. Sorry, the speaker wire. Glued it on this side. This is a hollow, flexible plastic tube. The speaker wire is running into the door. So when I shut the door, this part isn't glued. It's just in there. And when I shut the door, it goes with it. And I can open the door all the way, completely wide open. And it just stays in there and it works out pretty good. It's been there for, 9 years. So never had it kink or clip once. And then this is what is holding up the speaker. It's bolting onto this piece of wood that goes across the whole door for a better stability. And then we threw some hooks on it, my buddy's idea. And then we, oh, by the way, if you end up getting any of the SVS Ultras and piano, black piano gloss, or a black gloss piano, whatever the hell it is, definitely gonna want this. They get dusty. So, what else? I used to have Boston Acoustic ceiling speakers, which were flush, and they were installed a while ago. And when I decided to go to the SVS Prime elevation speakers, I had to figure out a way to see if I can light this up a little. I had to figure out a way to plug the hole. There's a big hole from the other speakers back there, or up there. So let me see if I can grab one of these things. If it'll light up better or not. That's a little better. So what I did was I cut a piece of plywood the exact size of the hole, a huge hole. It's bigger than it looks. I think these are 8-inch speakers. And I mounted the SVS to the plywood, and then there's another piece of wood up inside. It comes out to here, and the cool thing is that I can twist these any direction I want. Right now I have them facing the center chair there. They're all towed in each corner. That one's hard to see. But I have the ability to put them wherever I... A little sheetrock dust coming out there. So that's pretty cool. I haven't really messed around too much with them. The angle. I pretty much just set them facing the center chair, but that was another pretty neat little thing that we had to figure out how to do. I have not made the jump to 4K yet, and yes, this is only a 65-inch, but it is a 65-inch VT. Panasonic VT50, insane black levels, absolutely insane. The only thing that's better is OLED right now, and I have not, it's close, but I haven't felt the urge to take the jump yet. We'll see. I can fit a up to an 85-inch TV before it starts interfering with the center tower. So I'm not sure if I'm going to go that route or not, but I think an 85-inch would be fine. But we'll see what happens in the next year or so. And it is coming off the wall. I don't remember the name of this TV mount, but it's coming off the wall. It's hard to tell. It's about 2 feet. The reason why I did that is because, if you've ever seen, first of all, I want the towers away from the wall, and second of all, the PB16 Ultra subwoofers are quite large. I mean, they take up, I don't know exactly if they're 30, 31 or 32 inches long, but they stick out into my room pretty far. So I had to float that TV out, and it actually looks really, really awesome when the lights are out. I mean, the TV, it looks like the picture is floating in the, you know, out in the room. So it's a pretty cool effect. And that's it for this video. But if you guys got any questions, let me know. Don't be afraid to ask. All right. Thanks for watching.